Hi, welcome to the glass plate. In today's example, we're going to discuss what we had in the lecture on heat and mass transfer. Remember the evaporating sphere. I draw the sphere here. It has now diameter d. The concentration of vapor just at the edge or the surface we label C star, which is higher than the concentration far away from the sphere. This was our air refresher that is slowly evaporating. We did the analysis, but I only presented core steps. Today we're going to focus on how you arrive from the actual mass balance towards the solution. So, what we had was the differential equation, the mass balance, which reads as the change of the mass of the sphere equals minus k times the area times the driving force C star minus C inf. And we quickly went through this and we realized that what we need to find is how the diameter changes, the shrinking of the sphere. And therefore, we have to inspect in each of these terms where the diameter is hidden. And it goes as follows. The volume of a sphere is pi over 6 d cubed. The outer area of the sphere is pi d squared. These are the obvious ones, but there is also one hidden in k. K can be written as Sherwood times the diffusion coefficient, which I give a double dash, over d, the diameter itself, estimated from the flat plate. And you see that d is present at multiple locations, and we need to carefully try and find how that works. Okay, if I look at the time derivative here, basically, I need to take the differential of d cubed, rho s being a constant, pi over 6, obvious constants. So I can write this as pi over 6, rho sub s, and then the time derivative of what is left is d cubed. If we take this derivative, it spits back 3d squared, which is the derivative of d cubed, yeah, obviously, times d dt of the diameter itself. Okay, now I have everything loose and I need to try and wrap this up. Take a good look at the d's. I'm going to put the d's, let me shift over a little bit, apart on the left hand side. We got d squared here, but on the other side, the left side, there's a 1 over d and a d squared, so from these there is only a linear d left. Quickly denoted, these two give on the right hand side 1d. If I move that over to the left hand side, this square disappears, so I get here d dd t of the diameter. Everything that contains d is on this side. Everything that doesn't contain d should be on the other side. That's quite a bit. So let's see whether we can pick that up from all the scribbling that I did. Start with the minus sign. Then the pi's are out, because they are on both sides. Then there is 1 over 6 here and a 3, so there's a half on this side, move to the other side, give me a 2. Sherwood, in the example that we did, was also 2 times the 2 coming from this side, gives me a 4. What else is left? Sherwood itself is used, diffusion coefficient is left, driving force C star minus C inf is left. From this side, I get the density of the sphere, rho sub s, that goes under it. And then obviously, I need to check whether this is dimensionally correct. Concentration in kilogram per cube over density in kilogram per cube. So this is dimensionless. Dimension of d, meter square, per second. That's all dimension wise on the right hand side. Left hand side, meters per second, meter squared per second. So my equation is pretty okay. This one can be solved by integrating both sides. Let me do that here on this side of the board. If I integrate both sides, integrating d by itself, I move over this t dt to here. Now we get an integral of the function d times the d, capital D. So this gives me half d squared. Let's check whether that's correct. If I differentiate this, I should get back what is in the integrand. Differentiating d squared gives a 2 in front, killing the half. And I'm left over with d times the dd as is written here. So this is fine. On the other side, oh, these are all constants with respect to time. So that's going to be minus everything here, that is the 4 c star minus c inf over rho s diffusion coefficient times d, because I basically integrate dt, that's all that's there to be integrated. Shouldn't forget the integration constant, capital C. Move over a little bit so you can see what I'm doing. Check my dimensions. Meter squared, this part, dimensionless, meter squared per second times second, dimensionally correct. All that is needed is finding something for this C capital. And for instance, we could say at the beginning, so the sphere starts to evaporate from a given diameter, d0. Put that in here and you get a half d0 squared equals, yeah, this is a zero because it's time zero, is this capital C. Combine these two and you get what we had on the sheet in the lecture. Try and do this yourself and see the logic that we put in. And see that I constantly try to check whether it still makes sense. Dimensions and units are great for that. They are easy to compute and to bookkeep. And I can still see whether I'm on track. Try this yourself and you will see that it is not that complicated. But it needs quite some trying and doing and getting used to it. See you in the next movie.